Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to welcome you all today. My name is Alexander. I'm the admissions director at Pericles, and I will be moderating today's webinar. Now, today's webinar is another of those webinars that is very special, like the last one. And it is very special for a few reasons. First and foremost, we are launching a brand new course that we've never run before, Change Leadership for Lawyers, which is taught by our illustrious professor, Paul Engelke, who's master of interaction. And another reason is because we are still testing out a new PowerPoint design. So we'll have a quick question on that towards the end of the webinar. But today, as I said, Change Leadership for Lawyers, a new course for us all, and we're all very eager to learn. Before I go to the nitty-gritty, let me introduce the speakers today and guests of honor. So first and foremost, Marion Dent, who is our dean and professor. Marion, hi, very nice to see you today with us.
Good to
be here. And of course, Paul Engelke, who is also, believe it or not, a professor at Pericles, and he will be introducing the course today. So please give a warm welcome to Paul.
Thank you, everyone.
Yeah.
Hi, Paul.
And then, yeah, we'll begin just in a moment. And before we move on, let me review the agenda for today. I will very briefly focus on Pericles' story and tell you a little bit about programs and courses that we have. Then I will pass the proverbial torch to Paul, and I'm sure he has very informative and very interesting presentation on the course. That is going to be followed by a Q&A session where you can ask any questions of us about the course or maybe other courses. About this course, I mean, other courses or programs. And of course, we have, as usual, a promotion for you with prizes. So please stay until the end. And speaking of the promotions, it's what's called Simplify Your Life Week today in the United States, which is a very interesting holiday of sorts. We're going to talk about it a little bit later. But before we do that, let's talk about Pericles for a brief moment. So we started our journey in 1997, which puts us at almost 25 years of very successful operation. We actually have our anniversary on the 25th of September, if I'm not mistaken. Right, Marion?
24th, I think.
24th. Yeah, 24th. Apologies. Yeah, 24th of September. And we're going to have, or rather host, an anniversary party. So make sure you stay tuned for that and come and join us for the fun. Now, our courses and programs are tailored to lawyers and business people with extensive legal background. All our courses are taught by professors with hands-on experience as well as very experienced practical lawyers. They are all taught exclusively in English, so that's another bonus to look forward to polish your English skills. And we're very proud to have thousands of successful alumni, both in Russia and abroad, a lot of whom have either opened their own law firms in Russia or are working for leading ILFs here and there. And let us very briefly speak about the courses that we have. One of the notables is Approaching Legal English, which is actually taught by Professor Cannon, Professor Donald Cannon, who is here with us, who is actually preparing right now as we are communicating, as we are hosting this webinar, because he has, as he said, his lesson in an hour and a half. Now, Approaching Legal English is one of those courses that is designed for people who want to brush up on their grammar, who have learned English quite a while ago, maybe at school or at university, and maybe are not using English as much as they would love to at work or in general life, day-to-day affairs. And it helps them to also remember vocabulary and practice speaking, because there's a lot of speaking in Donald's class, believe you me. It is extremely interactive, and it uses very, very unique methodology to bring you up to speed, so to speak. If you want to know more, you can ask us a little later. Moving forward, we also have a legal English class, which is more, shall we say, in-depth. It teaches you general legal vocabulary and special terminology that you as lawyers will need, not only in your studies, but also it's very useful for your day-to-day work. It also explores legal nuances between the Anglo-American legal system and Russian legal system, and nuances which often are a cause of misunderstandings and misinterpretations, and are very, very dangerous, and you know, can lead you to the situation as, you know, let's eat grandma, depending where you put the comma, you have a certain meaning. And of course, it is taught by native speaking lawyers. So that is another big bonus here. You actually learn from the best and people who know what they're doing in this particular area. Legal writing is, in my opinion, one of the most important courses because it, you know, focuses on such things as best practices for analytical legal writing. If you need to draft documents such as memorandums or client letters or things like that, it teaches you the famous IRAC methods and focuses on macro organization, which means that you organize the way you organize your argument throughout the whole legal document. And of course, micro organization, which helps you deal with punctuation, that pesky punctuation, the sentence structure, the sentence organization within an extract or, you know, a text in general. And one of the, I would say, most precious prizes, so to speak, that you get from legal writing is individual correction. The professor will actually address you individually in terms of what things need to be polished and corrected and improved. So that is, in my personal opinion, invaluable. And I actually am looking forward to taking this course myself at some point. And of course, we have negotiations for lawyers. We all know that negotiations are very important in our life. We negotiate everywhere and with everyone. And of course, it's wonderful to get from no to yes, but it's designed for lawyers who need to represent clients and helps you represent them more effectively through hands-on negotiations practice during the courses. And in addition to that, the professor also compiles your individualized profile. So it helps you make your negotiation style more in tune with who you are and your techniques. And finally, last but not least, our very special baby, the LLM program, which is a fully fledged master's degree for lawyers, which gives, in my personal opinion, a real edge and is extremely practical. And the reason it is extremely practical is because it was designed in collaboration with the leading international legal firms like Baker McKenzie, Daly Piper, Deckard, White & Case, you name it. And it happened 20 years ago when you know, Marion and her colleagues went to those ILFs and the councils and senior partners and asked them, hey guys, what would you like to see in your future partners in terms of skills and expertise? And they gave a good list of things that they want to see. And on the top of the list, it was writing, and more writing. So that's one of the focuses, of course, as I previously mentioned, for example, for such courses as legal writing. And you get pretty much very, very practical experience that you can then use in your practice wherever you go. It also teaches you to think like a real lawyer. And another bonus, it is much less expensive compared to American or European LLMs, but it's maybe, I will, you know, go on the limb here, but it's in some ways even much better than those. Anyway, the applications, submissions are open now. We're gonna have our orientation on from September 14th through 16th. So if you have any questions, please email us at admissions@paraclis.ru, call us. There is also a QR code that you can scan to read a little bit more about our LLM program. And if you want to apply, we'll be happy to have you. And if you have any questions, as I said, please send us an email or call us up.
As now, Alexander mentioned, the applications are open now. So that means by September 14th through 16th, this is not like an open day. Your application has to be in before that date to participate in the orientation. So now through the beginning of September is the latest you can apply for this semester.
Right. Thank you for that clarification, Marion, of course. Yes. So guys, make sure if you're interested to apply right now within the next couple of weeks so we can process it, because it does take a little bit of time. Now we're getting to the nitty gritty of it, to the meat of it, to the actual course. And you know what? I'm not going to bore you with my explanations because honestly, I don't really know what the course is going to be about. I know that, you know, in the current very, I guess, stressful and tough situation that we're all living through, changes are very quick, and sometimes we need a lot of time to adapt to them to make sure that we understand what's going on and to make sure that, you know, we can go forward in the best and most productive way. So I will pass on the proverbial torch to our Professor Engelke here to talk about the course. I am actually very eager to take this course this next fall semester, so I hope to see some of you guys there as well with me. Professor Engelke, please take the stage, and we're looking forward to that wonderful presentation of yours.
Thank you. Thank you, Alexander, and welcome to all students, old and new. It's always always exciting and a pleasure for me to meet the new students as well as the old. Alexander, you are an absolute superstar when it comes to doing these marketing presentations.
I try.
I feel intimidated by your whole presence. Wonderful. Perfect. Thanks for that.
I'll make myself small.
So good evening, everyone. I'm calling you, I suppose, or holding or hosting this webinar from a very cold South Africa on the African continent. It's 16 degrees in the room I'm sitting in. So it is, for me, for an African, is quite cold. I'm very excited. And when Dean Marion Dent asked me to have a look at presenting this course, I was excited and I said, yes, let's do it. And I've been doing quite a bit of extensive research in the last couple of weeks in preparation for the course. I'm not finished yet, reading books like crazy. And this is what I've come up with and what you are going to experience from the 24th of September, if you join me. And I want to encourage you to hang on tight, because it's going to be quite a rough ride and it's going to be like a roller coaster. So you're going to be doing a lot of the work that we're going to be doing in the course will be pretty much hands-on. I will facilitate the transfer of the theoretical knowledge from me to you as a student. But then once you've got that knowledge in the first hour and a half of a lesson, you are going to have to take that knowledge and actually apply it to your own scenario, which I'm going to address in the next couple of minutes. So if you can just give me a chance, I want to share my screen with a presentation that I have created for this webinar. And let's hope this works. Alexander, can I ask you to be my soundboard? Can you see my screen?
Yep, I can see your screen with a lot of slides on the left and main slide on the in the front.
Right, let me make it into a slideshow. Thank you. Okay, so here we go, guys. This is going to be exciting. I'm looking forward to it. It's going to change, hopefully, the way you approach changes. Now, all of us, every day, every single day, we are faced with changes. And this is what life is about. We wake up and there's a traffic jam. And now you're going to be late for work and you have to change your schedule. We take it for granted. But I want you to start I want you to start changing your attitude to change. And I want you to be more structured in the way you manage change. And once you understand these principles that we are going to discuss on this course, you're going to become a leader in change. And that's ultimately where I want to get you, as a lawyer, to get you as an in-house lawyer, to get you as a consultant, to become a leader in change. So you're going to have clients, you're going to have corporations for whom you work, who are going to be in a tizz. They're going to be freaking out because certain suppliers can no longer supply them from Europe. And what are we going to do? How are we going to deal with this? What about the contracts? What about the negotiations? What about supplier? Calm down. That's where you, the lawyer, where I expect you, the lawyer, to take control and to to address the directorship and give them guidance, not only from a legal perspective, but from a change leader perspective as well. Hey, exciting. Okay, so let's have a look at what we're going to be dealing with. Oh, goodness me, how do I move this thing out of the way? There we go. Domina Quo Vadis, what the hell does that mean? Holy moly. Don't worry. If you know your Bible, when Peter, after he denied Jesus, when Jesus came out from the temple, he said to his Lord, Domine Quo Vadis, Master, where are we going? Where are we going? So I'm telling you guys, this is where we're going. I'm going to show you the direction, and I'm going to hand over the reins to you after 6 weeks, and then you will be showing the direction. Isn't that what where you want to be? You will be the leader. So an organization will always go through various changes in its lifetime. We as lawyers deal with changes in legislation. Every time the Russian Duma sits, we know there's going to be a new law, a new regulation, a new legislative change or an amendment that's going to come out. And you're going to have to advise your company, your firm, your clients about the changes and how to implement the changes and what they should do to change it. That's a simple thing that us lawyers do every single week. It's a no-brainer. Okay, what about pandemics? Suddenly there's a COVID virus that's doing the rounds around the globe. It's causing havoc. People are changing the way they think, the way they live. They're now working from home. I'm giving lessons, which I would never have done 2 years ago. From the comfort of my lounge, I'm giving a lesson to a group of guys in Russia. Mind-blowing stuff, really. But now we take it for granted. Jeez, man, Nichivo, not a big deal. It is a big deal. And we need to adapt to these changes. Political changes. There's a new leader in a country. There's a new minister. A new minister of finance. He changes the policies, the fiscal policies, the tax policies. You have to be up there with the changes, and you need to know how to implement the change and adapt to these changes in the political policies. Global social attitudes. You can't believe it. A couple of years ago, a lawyer friend of mine works for VW here in South Africa, Volkswagen Motor Corporation. He told me, Paul, by 2024, there won't be any more diesel petrol vehicles being made in the world. I said, nonsense, crap, bull dust. He says, mark my words, by 2024, VW, Ford, Volvo will not be making internal combustion engines anymore. Well, where are we? 2022, and China are busy changing all their assembly lines to produce electric cars. 5 years, it changed, and there's busy changes. We need to understand these global social attitudes against climate change, against global warming, against the use, the sustainable use of natural resources, to start reducing the consumption of fossil fuels, oil, gas, gasoline, diesel. And now we're changing to lithium, cobalt, to using batteries instead. Sorry, I get very excited about these things, but we as lawyers are sort of thick-skinned. We sort of deal with these things as every day. But it's a big deal, and there are people who are actually going to see psychologists because they can't keep up with the changes, and they need leaders to help them understand the change. They need leaders at work to say to them, hey, it's okay, it's all right. We've got this. We've got this. Follow me. I know where I'm going. Domine Quo Vadis. Follow me. I'm the master. International armed conflict. Need I say more? Need I say more? We know what we're referring to here. Things were going quite smoothly in Russia, and suddenly we woke up and things had changed. Things had changed. And from then on, it's been a roller coaster ride. We've been sanctioned. We've been sanctioned. We've been sanctioned. We can't get products anymore from Europe. We can't get products anymore from America. We have to change the way we think. We are now looking towards the East. We are now going to China. We're now going to Southeast Asia. We're now going to Africa. And we're starting to do transactions with these countries. We're starting to form trade blocks, BRICS. And now suddenly, it's become the norm. And it's no longer a train smash. Why? Because we are dealing with it. But how many corporations have closed down? How many corporations have reduced their work staff, their employees, to deal with these changes? A lot of people's lives have been devastated. They need leaders, because we don't want people to panic. We don't want people, our directors, our board of directors, our shareholders, to start panicking and closing down shop and to start putting people off. That's the worst case scenario. And they need a strong leader. They need a lawyer. They need you to be able to guide them and to say to them, we've got this. We've got this. We can handle this. And that's what I'm going to be sharing with you in the next couple of weeks when the course starts. Okay, let's go to the second point here. After all, adaption is one of the key factors in and to an organization's survival. And if you're part of that organization, you need to be part of the solution and not part of the problem. You need to be the one standing up and saying, I know what to do. I know how to do this. Okay. So the in-house lawyer, the consultant, the associate must be well-versed in change leadership to be able to lead their clients successfully through the constant changes happening around us. This will not only give you, the lawyer, the in-house lawyer, the advocate, that competitive advantage that we are all striving for. Every company, every professional is looking for that competitive advantage, that little edge, huh, to put you ahead of the rat race. But your reputation and your goodwill, if it's a company, your goodwill will improve tremendously. And in so doing, your client base as well. If your client base is increased through word of mouth or through your professional marketing strategies, your bottom line suddenly looks better. And suddenly you're more profitable. And suddenly you're thriving on change and you're not crumbling under the change. Oh, I'm so excited. I want to do this course now. Okay. Let's go on. So there are several well-accepted change leadership models that are doing their rounds in the world. And the folk who are in those circles tell me that there are four or five very well adapted, well-balanced leadership models that any company is encouraged to take hold of and start adapting and adopting. So we as lawyers, we can refer to any of these leadership models in your own practice. All of them have been scientifically proven to be effective in the leadership of change. So the leadership of change, not the management of change, but the leadership of change. That's where I want to get you guys to start changing that attitude. Don't manage change, but lead the change. In this course, however, starting in September, we'll be focusing on the teachings of one of the leading authorities in change leadership, namely a writer, a professor, called John Cotter. Okay, so who is John Cotter? Let me quickly tell you about the author and the book that we'll be using. So John Paul Cotter is a professor of leadership emeritus at the Harvard Business School. He's an author. He's the founder of Cotter International and management consulting firm based in Seattle and Boston. And I love this. He's a thought leader in business leadership and change. A thought leader. How's that? A thought leader. I think all the time, but no one has given me the title of thought leader. So I'm thinking about how do I become a thought leader? So he is a thought leader. He changes people's minds. He changes the way you think. He changes your attitudes by his process and his models that he has invented and changed and adapted. Okay, he's also an internationally known and widely regarded as the foremost speaker on the topics of leadership and change. His is the premier voice on how best organizations actually achieve successful transformation. So this is the go-to guy. This is the go-to guy. And I, with Marion's help, we've decided to use Cotter as the basis for this course. So we'll be using his resource, his book. So the resource we're using, the book is called Leading Change. So if you want to go and do some research, if you want to find the book for yourself, it's called Leading Change and it's written by John Paul Cotter. Okay, so you're all welcome to acquire this book, although it won't be necessary for this course, as I will be providing you with the course material before the course starts and throughout the course. So once you have registered, once Pericles have got you on their database, I will provide you with the material that you will need for the first lesson, lecture. And then throughout every lesson, you'll be given further material for the next lesson. And there's a reason for that, because I want to do this course step by step. I don't want you to start going ahead of me, because then you're going to get confused. So we're going to go through this course step by step and together, and we're going to develop and grow as a group, as a class, together. Okay. Approach and methodology. We will be following a theoretical and a practical approach to mastering the skills learned in this course or on this course. At the beginning of the course, students will provide me, that's you, you will provide me with a possible, I like this, innovative and a real-time change scenario from your own work environment. So what does that mean? Let me just slow down, Spokoenya. Let me just get my composure again, because I get very excited when I start talking about these things. You as a student, you're going to go back to your workplace, to your work environment. And it doesn't have to be work environment. You can also go to your private life, but that might be a little risky. Find a situation in your own workplace that you feel is archaic, that you feel is not streamlined, where you feel that it could be improved. It could be done better. And you might have some ideas, or it could be a frustration, you know, like perhaps the in-house platform that you use to communicate with each other. You might think there must be a better way that we can communicate, that we can send mails to each other, that the bosses and my partners can send the associates messages, maybe. So you want to go digital and you want to try a different platform. But you know there are some old guys sitting there. There are some fossils, some dinosaurs sitting there that's going to resist this. And they've been using it for years and they are quite happy with what they're doing. And there's going to be serious resistance to change. However, if you package this proposal of yours and if you sell it to them in a way that they can't resist, in a way that they can't say no, you might get what you want. You might get a more streamlined, cost-effective, time-saving digital process put into place. They might buy into it and they might give you the budget, give you the money to start the new digital platform within your company or within your law firm. So whatever it is, it could be the library system. It could be your library that you use, your resource database. It might be slow. You want to change it and you want to put something new in there. Usually, if I speak to colleagues in the workplace, they tell me that they're going digital and they're using some high-tech platforms and software that's not always easy to understand. And because these software programs are not easy, people have a resistance to it. They want to keep doing what they were doing. They want to stay in the comfort zone. So your job before the course starts is to find an area in your workplace that you're not comfortable with, that you want to change. It could even be the working hours. Good luck to that one. Come to me with it. Give me a paragraph telling me, this is what I would like to change. I'm going to put it on file. I'm going to keep it with me. And together, we are going to implement John Cotter's 8-point model to your scenario, to your unique scenario. And you're going to keep a file with you. And we're going to build on this file. And each step, we're going to add something. And you're going to give me a report after each week telling me how this step in the model has affected how you've implemented this to your scenario. Okay, you guys still with me, don't lose me. Students will study Cotter's 8-step model or process of change leadership. After each step in the process, students will apply the principles to their scenario and provide me with a short report on the relevance and how the step applies practically to your unique scenario. Okay, I'm just looking for a paragraph. I want to see that you understand the theory, that you can apply the theory to your scenario. Okay. Every week, and after each step, your thesis, I'm calling it the thesis for now, call it a portfolio, we can call it what you want. Your file, your thesis, your portfolio will grow and develop until you have a complete, feasible, viable, and a working solution for your change leadership scenario. At the end of the course, you're going to be able to take this to your board of directors, to your partner, to your mentor, and say, listen, I've got the answer. Here it is. This is what we should do. And this is how we're going to do it. Okay, exciting. Guys, these principles don't only have to apply to a change scenario at work. You can apply it to your own private life as well. If you want to start getting fit, if you want to not be a couch potato anymore, you can apply these change principles to your own life and stop eating chocolates and use less sugar in your coffee or whatever. Okay. So what are these steps? Guys, I'm coming to an end. I know I'm becoming long-winded, but forgive me for that. We're approaching the end. Kotter's 8-step change model for management. What is it? What are we getting all excited about here? What is going to change your lives and what's going to make your life at work easier? This is it. First of all, we're going to discuss. We are going to discuss. Initiate urgency. You as a leader will have to initiate urgency. You will have to get fire going under these people's backsides. You're going to have to try and understand where they are in their comfort zone, and you're going to have to start making that comfort zone a little less comfortable for them. Okay, so you want to initiate urgency. So every organization needs to establish a sense of urgency within the employees to effectively implement change. So you need to start selling the idea slowly to these guys. They should be able to explain, you should be able to explain properly why this is important and urgent for the company's survival. Why is it important that we need to change? Are we going to save money? Is it going to be cost effective? Are we going to become more out there? Is it going to be good for marketing? Are we going to be more prominent in the legal fraternity in Moscow or in whatever city I'm working in? Two, change team. You need to choose your team very well. You don't want to choose guys that are resistant to this. You want to get the flamboyant, energetic, the Alexanders that spoke to you earlier in this world. You want to get them on your change team. This team should involve respected members of the company and department leaders impacted by the change. So these guys who will definitely be impacted by the change, you want them on your team. You don't want them sitting there criticizing you. You want them to be part of the solution, not part of the problem. So you're going to be clever here. You're going to recruit them and pull them in. Start with them. They should be able to influence teamwork in the organization. Okay, very important. They should be the influencers. Thirdly, we're going to establish a vision. This is going to be around about week 3, week 4. Establish a vision. Okay, an organization with a clear vision on how and where it wants to be in the future will be able to direct its employees in achieving its goals. The first thing I saw when I came to Moscow was Lenin. And Lenin was pointing in that direction. He was showing the people which way they're going. You are going to be the Lenin. You're going to be showing your people which way you want to go. How do you do it? You create a vision, but you package it, and we'll help you on this course to package it in a way that cannot be denied. Okay, so that vision we will create, and you will create, and you'll put it in your portfolio, and we'll see how we can develop it later, because you need to communicate the vision. That's week 4. The vision must be communicated properly. You're not going to throw it on people's desk. You're not going to send an email. You're going to create a presentation. You're going to call all the influencers and decision makers into a room, and you're going to say, guys, I've been working on this in my private time, not company hours, my time. And this is something I want to share with you. Employees must be able to understand it thoroughly and comply with the company's vision of the future. So it's not your vision. It's also in terms of the company's vision. So you want to incorporate this vision of change into the company's vision, where they're going. And when the two are married, it's a match made in heaven. Empower others. Oi. Empower others. Employees who feel that they are empowered by the firm to achieve this vision will be more motivated to operate within the transition. So you're going to give little people a bit of responsibility. And when he gets that right, when he achieves that little goal, you're going to give him a bigger goal and he's going to feel better and good about himself. Maybe one of the interns, the newbies. And so this guy gains more confidence and he's liking. So for example, if it's a computer software program, we're going to start with small stuff. We're going to teach him how to send an email using this. Then we're going to teach him how to send an internal memo. And then we're going to show him how to do a proposal and then a written legal opinion using this. Slowly, we're going to develop and advance, go to the more advanced stages. So this creates a sense of responsibility for the employees. Easy goals. By creating short-term goals and rewarding employees for achieving it, the company will achieve the bigger vision in a step-by-step approach. A bit of a bonus, you know? Get it right. You've got Friday afternoon off. You can go down the road and have a couple of beers with your mates. Or if she wants to get Friday off to go and get her hair done or get the nails done or whatever the case may be. I don't want to sound that I'm discriminating against sexes here, but you want to give small little bonuses to these folk. Okay, more goals. After achieving the short-term goals, new ones should be immediately followed in order for the firm to be able to achieve the bigger and the ultimate goal of accepting the change and going forward into the future with this new change. And then, of course, we need to embrace the culture. The final step in this change model of management is to permanently institutionalize the new approaches, make it part of the corporate culture by embedding them into the company's culture and leadership succession. There's a lot of going on there. The leadership succession. Don't do that after a couple of drinks. Okay, so this is it. It might look boring, but it's not. You're going to enjoy it and you're going to create something out of nothing. And when you finish this course, you will have something that you can take back and use with the corporate culture, with your firm or with your private life. Ladies and gentlemen, my story is finished. 6 weeks and we're going to start 24th of September, if I'm not mistaken. And it's going to be time well spent, I can assure you. Thank you, Marion. Thank you, Alexander.
Well, the thank you is ours, really, Paul, here, because it was very interesting, very sort of packed with a lot of information, very emotional, as usual. So thank you for that. I'm not sure I will be able to refuse chocolates. What if the chocolate is sugar-free? You know? Best of both worlds.
Yeah.
Anyway, speaking of the thought leader, I'm sure you will become one, at least for the students after this course. So we'll prepare a thought leader diploma for you or certificate or something like that. I'm sure we'll figure something out. Anyway, so again, guys, this is going to be a brand new course for us. We've never run it before. And it's going to be extremely interesting and interactive. I can see it from how Paul, you know, very sort of, he's into that himself. And I know when people from experience, when people are like that, it's going to go very well. And it's going to be fun to be there and to actually learn what you can use in real life, which is what we're all about. Now, before we jump to the Q&A, and while, you know, we're jumping in the process of jumping, think of the questions you want to ask Paul. I know I have one possible question already, but before we go there, let me quickly just share a screen to go to the promotion, because that's something also important. Okay, let's see here. So as I said before, today is the Make It Simpler Week holiday, very interesting holiday in the United States. And so in tune with the changes, in tune with the change leadership and managing change and leading change, what I want you to do is to send me to my email, which is admissions@pericles.ru, and maybe a short abstract, a short story of how did you manage change? How did you lead change in your life, maybe in your profession? It doesn't have to be very long. Just what was the change? How did you react to that or did respond to it? How did you manage it and take leadership for that? And how did you make
it? Does it have to be in English, Alexander?
Yes, it does. Of course. I'm looking for English, not Russian. I don't need Russian. I can read a Russian book for that. but make it in English and tell me, how did you address the change? How you made it simpler and more understandable, and maybe enticed others to follow you in your footsteps? As I said, nothing too complex, something simple and easy. And the person who sends me the most interesting, the most unusual approach is gonna get the prize. Maybe several of you, I don't know. Depends on what you write there and what cases you will tell me about. So with that done, let's jump to the Q&A session. And guys, if you have any questions about the course or other courses that we have, as well as the LLM program, we are an open book. Please throw your questions at us. We're here to answer. I know I have one possible question from Donald. Can you give us an example of a leadership scenario that you described, maybe that actually happened, or maybe it should have happened, but for some reason didn't? That, you know, something from history, maybe a real life, maybe your experience, Paul, that you've actually seen, that the example that worked or didn't work because the leadership wasn't there, for example.
Alexander, you're asking me?
Yes, it's a question for you.
Yes, very interesting. I started working as a young prosecutor in Cape Town, South Africa. And it was awful. We arrived with no experience. We just came out of university. And the magistrate, those years we felt, the prosecutors fell under the court's magistrate. And there was a senior prosecutor and a senior magistrate. And for some unknown reason, the court that we were assigned to, it was Weinberg, both the magistrate and the senior prosecutor resigned the week that we arrived. So we were literally in the deep end. We had no idea what a court docket would look like. And we arrived there, and each of us, there were six of us, six young prosecutors, we had case dockets like this on the desk. It was absolutely awful without leadership. And like you said, we expected to be mentored. We expected to have someone guiding us for at least the first month. And no, we were thrown in on the deep end. And we appeared before different magistrates who were so angry at our incompetence. Alexander, I cannot tell you how fast we learnt and how quickly we learnt how to think on our feet. You know, and to listen to little nuances, little cues, little prompts from the bench. If this guy said to you, would you like to re-examine? Yes, I would like to re-examine. But so the point is, every group, every bunch of newcomers look to you, someone who's got more experience. Even if you're not a leader, people will be looking up to you. And we were using the court interpreters for help, the interpreters for help, because they knew, they've been sitting there every day for the last 5-6 years. So they knew the system, they knew the processes. So we would go to them during tea breaks. What now? What do we do now? How do we do this? And they would help us. Guys with no legal background, but who understood the process. So leadership is so important in especially in a professional occupation, because you don't get taught these things at university, and you look up to someone who's got, even so, that old expression, in the land of the blind, one eye is king. So if you've got any experience, please share that with the new guys coming in. Share your experience. Don't hold back. Don't try and keep the information to yourself. We were all there in that very lonely place at one stage. Yeah, so leadership's very important, and you don't have to be this rock star leader. Just sharing information, just guiding, prompting, nudging is already a huge help. Alexander.
So did you lead the change to make sure that the, you know, your successors will have leadership?
Definitely. We had a different approach to the guys coming in after that. We made sure there were programs in place, you know, to help them.
Yeah. All right.
I have to tell you, Paul, that I'm going to try to attend your class because there's when we had to move from being online or in person and seeing each other to be online, I remember how we tried to implement the changes and implement particular programs, same page and things that where we could work people together. And I didn't do as good a job as I would have hoped to get this done. We got part of the team working well together, but we failed in incorporating the teachers into this. So we had the team, the core team of Pericles working together, but in the long run, it failed because the teachers weren't on board. And so we had, I had to do a better job of explaining and onboarding and telling them why we needed this, because the teachers who spent only part of their time in the office and the rest of the time were working from home were fine because they didn't see any need for a change. And we who were normally working together face-to-face all the time, we saw a huge need for teams for a change. So we had a big split. And I'm looking forward to learning how to handle that kind of thing and onboarding people into change leadership a little better.
Good.
Onboarding clients too as a lawyer, I think it's
correct. Yes.
Absolutely necessity.
Yeah. Absolutely. Absolutely.
Yeah,
Thanks for that.
So am I. Yeah, I'm absolutely attending this one. Anyway, we got a couple more questions. So Olga Maxim was asking, will it be online or offline? If I'm not mistaken, Olga, it's going to be a mixed sort of course, which means that some lessons will be strictly online, some will be strictly offline. That depends on Paul, because as far as I know, Paul is coming to Russia. And if he manages to come earlier, then it's going to be probably offline. If he doesn't and gets delayed a little bit, then maybe some of the lessons are going to take place online. Marian,
Alexander, can we clarify that a little bit? Nothing will be strictly offline.
Oh, okay.
All courses are available online. So it's either going to be fully online. If Paul Engelke doesn't manage to lead the change of his visa situation. And if he does manage to do that, then it will be bimodal, meaning students will have the option to come in person in Moscow or to be online.
Okay,
good. Yeah, thanks for that clarification. Perhaps I mixed it up with another course, because I do remember there's bimodal and offline somewhere on our schedule. Yeah,
We don't have any fully offline courses. They're all
not anymore. Yeah, not anymore.
Bimodal or online.
Okay. Another question here. Since you know the importance of change and how much you need energetic leadership to implement change, how can you bring about change in fossilized systems, like for example, in old corporations and organizations?
Who asked that question? May I know who's
addressing you? Yeah, that's Donald's question.
Donald, there's a whole lesson based just on resistance to change and how to change people's... it's not easy. And I like the way you use the word fossilized. We have to try and bring life into these old bones, and we will. So there are some very nice tools that they have, that this Cotter has suggested and recommended. But it's always a challenge trying to get those folk who are comfortable where they are to go from a place of comfort to a place of not comfortable or discomfort. And we do address that. So do you regard yourself as one of those fossils, Donald?
Yes and no. When I'm on the one side, I'm very fossilized. When I'm trying to do it the other way, I'm trying to get people to break all of those bones and try new things.
Yes, yes. I completely understand you. Yeah.
Good. So maybe we should all attend this course.
Yeah.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, any other questions? We are very looking forward to your questions if you have any. No, not at all.
Everybody's hiding out.
Yeah, everyone is hiding behind the black screen.
When they come to the actual class, they'll have to show themselves and participate, right? Yeah. But for today, everybody gets to hide out.
Oh, well, it's one of those Zoom problems that you can just sort of switch off your camera.
Yeah.
What is the price? Okay, it's one credit course, if I'm not mistaken, right, Marion?
That's right.
So the price for our LLM students is going to be $2,400 or $2,500, I think, right?
Right. If they're registered by Monday, by the close of business on Monday, then it's $2,250.
So right. So if you're registered by Monday, then
individual LLM students. For non-LLM students, the price is 40,000 rubles, and there's a discount if you're registered at least 2 weeks before the course starts, and a slightly lesser discount if you're registered 1 week before the course starts. If you're being paid by your company, the price is slightly higher, it's 5,000 rubles higher. And this is because we give your company the option to, if you, for example, have to leave the company, then they can transfer the course to someone else. And they have these options. You know, this person we put in this course got sent on a business trip, can't do it. We want to substitute in someone, and then that way they can do it. So that's part of the reason why we have more.
Okay, how to apply for this course? This is a very good question. It's fairly easy. What you need to do, you need to go to our website, which is www.pericles.ru. Let me just type it in the chat. There we go. And once you're on the website, in the top right corner, you will see login button on a bright orange background, I guess. Yellow or orange, depends, or red, if you want to call it that way. You click on it, you create an account, and once you are in, you will have the option to register for a course, and you just register for, you open the drop-down menu, and you register for that course for Change Leadership for Lawyers. You pick the date. There are three fields, the course itself, the date, and the group. Well, we only have one group, so that one will probably be grayed out. And then you click, register for it. You can actually add any number of courses through your personal account on our website. That will also create an account on Moodle that you will use as a system to, you know, exchange materials and to download or upload study materials. So, and if I took two Pericles courses in the past, no discount, is that right? Well,
taking additional courses, but you still get the early enrollment discount if you get into the course on time. And of course, Olga, think about taking our LLM program. If you've taken two courses in the past, you know, it's time to start thinking about joining the LLM.
Absolutely. That's actually something I was going to say. Yeah. Think about joining the LLM. You're going to save a considerable amount if you do. No problem. Our pleasure. Anyway, any more questions, guys? Anything else you would like to know or ask us about? No? Not at all? Yeah. Okay. So in that case, to the set conversation. We do have actually, if I remember correctly, another webinar that is going to be on the 11th.
Yes.
Right. That's going to be dedicated to European Union law.
European with our Union expansion.
Expansion.
Is it not? Ukraine has been granted fast track into the EU. What does that really mean? Professor Moritz Knaff is going to talk to us about that. And also, you'll get a taste of how he teaches his European Union law course, which is also going to be going on this fall.
All right. Yeah. So I'm actually also looking forward to that one. It's going to be a lot of fun. So make sure you sign up.
Yeah. And also we'll have Eileen Grenna from Delaware Law School also mentioning about the Delaware joint Pericles Delaware Law Masters of Jurisprudence program and dual MJ program.
Right, right. So a lot of interesting information coming up very soon. And we'll be looking forward to see you there. Now, again, very much, I would like to thank you very much for attending our today webinar. It was fun. Paul, thank you very, very much that you gave such an important, I think, and very emotional presentation. I'm sure people are enticed to, you know, join your class. I know I am. And if you would like to email us with any questions or call us with any questions, you can see our information on the screen right there. Or if you want to come in person, we always have tea, coffee, and cookies. So you know, if you are partial to that. Yes, Karina, we will, if you need, send out the presentation. I will ask Paul to send it out to me and I will send it with the follow-up letter. For those of you who are tech savvy, there is a QR code on the screen that you can scan for all our social media and telephone numbers and whatnot to have it handy, or you can also share it. And also, please, guys, if you don't already, please follow us on our social media, on our Telegram, on our Vkontakte, and other social media platforms to keep up to date, or rather to stay up to date with our announcements, with free webinars, events, and so on and so forth. Thank you very much for being with us tonight. It was a great pleasure to have you. And we anticipate to see you at our courses and programs in the coming semester. Thanks a lot. Have a wonderful, wonderful evening and the upcoming weekend. Thank you, guys.
And thank you guys. Professor Engelke, for a great presentation and introduction to your course.
Yes, thank you very much.
My pleasure. Thanks, everybody. Good night.
Bye-bye, guys. Thank you very much.
Bye-bye.
Thank you. Goodbye.